الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. All praise be to Allah عز وجل. We praise Him, with Him we seek aid and help, to Him we repent. With Allah, glory be to Him, we seek refuge from the evil of our souls and from our bad deeds. Whosoever Allah Azza wa Jal guides, none can misguide. Whosoever Allah Azza wa Jal misguides, none can guide. I bear witness that none has the right to be worshipped but Allah Azza wa Jal, and that Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is His messenger and His servant. Allah the Exalted has said, which translated means, O who you believe, fear Allah as he should be feared, and do not die unless in a state of Islam. Before, we were talking regarding the worship of the creatures to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that all the creatures moving or non-moving, living or non-living, are worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Exalted, has said in the Quran, أَلَمْ تَرَ أَنَّ اللَّهَ يَسْجُدُ لَهُ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَالشَّمْسُ وَالْقَمَرُ وَالنُّجُومُ وَالْجِبَالُ وَالشَّجَرُ وَالدَّوَابُ وَكَثِيرٌ مِّنَ النَّاسِ وَكَثِيرٌ حَقَّ عَلَيْهِ الْعَذَابُ وَمَنْ يُهِنِ اللَّهُ فَمَا لَهُ مِنْ مُكْرِمٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is like informing and telling us that everything Allah has created is worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and under the commandment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and also thankful to Allah, dutiful to Allah, worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala according to the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, according to the way they understand, according to the way Allah knows about them. As-samawat wal-ard. So we're talking before about as-samawat, the heavens, the seven heavens, and the seven earths. The mountain, they are worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are bowed down for Allah, and prostrating for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to Allah azza wa jal. السماوات والأرض والشمس والقمر, even the sun, and we're talking about the sun. Allah has mentioned that والشمس تجري لمستقر لها ذلك تقدير العزيز العليم, that every day, every single day, the sun is running to be settled, to be set under the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and prostrate in the front, by you know, between the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, under the throne, with full submission to Allah, worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, thankful to Allah azza wa jal, dutiful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, respecting Allah azza wa jal, every single day. And we're talking that the sun reacting and has a feeling, you know, according to the pleasure of Allah or the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the sun is in a bound down every single day, and the sun think that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is the end of the life, this is the end of the world, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will destroy everything, because what the sun have seen from the sins and wrongdoing from the wrongdoers and from the sinners. And we're talking regarding the reaction of the sun, that the sun like have this feeling, and the believers should have the same feeling or better than the sun, you know, according to the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or the anger of Allah, or the curse of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon the wrongdoers. And we're talking about the hadith, the authentic hadith, the Prophet ﷺ was saying that in the authentic hadith, أوثق عور الإيمان الحب في الله والبغض في الله. The most strong among the nuts of the faith is to love for the sake of Allah and to hate for the sake of Allah, to give for the sake of Allah and to deny or not to give for the sake of Allah, and also to marry for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, means to make your life, your actions, your parts according to the sake of Allah, according to the commandments of Allah, according to the rules of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so you are under the commandment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, under the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to fulfill the words and the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So to hate for the sake of Allah and to love for the sake of Allah. Most of people today, they believe that Islam is just love. Islam doesn't have hatred, doesn't have to hate people, doesn't have to have like hostility, doesn't have to have enmity against the sinners. No, Islam is part to hate and part to love. So in Islam, Islam is not just love, just like the other people claim that their religion, their false religion, just mahabba, just to love. And even if somebody hates you, in one side you have to give him the other side. No, Islam is different. Islam, the religion of Jesus, is different than what people believe today. Islam, the religion of Moses, is different than what people are believing today. Islam, the religion of Allah, the religion of all the messengers, all the prophets, is different completely than what people understood or understand it today. Islam is to love for the sake of Allah, not to love for your own desire, not to love for your own relative or your own people or your own tribe or your own nationality or your own language or your own country or your own land. No, Islam is to love for the sake of Allah. Means every single Muslim, every single believer should be your beloved. And even if this Muslim, even if this believer is your enemy, or you have some problem with him, he's the one who killed your father, for example, or the one who killed your brother, as long as he's a believer, he's a Muslim, we should give him the desire and the feeling, you know, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also that means whosoever disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or disbelieve in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or whoever not following or not practicing according to the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I should have reaction against him. I should have bad feeling toward him, even if he is my father, or he is my brother, he is my son, he is my daughter, he is my wife. Even though he is the closest person for me, I have to react against that. I have to hate his actions. I have to remind him. I have to stop him from this as much as I can. I have to react. I have to show Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala some reaction according to that I am according or under his request, under his commandment, under his word, under his religion, under his way, under his guidance. I should put my desire and my feeling in my hand according to the request of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, according to the religion of Allah, according to the guidance of and the actions and the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, even though if he is people or my close people. So I have to hate the sinners even if they are close to me. I have to love the believers and the dutiful people and the pious people for the sake of Allah, even if they are different nationality, different color, different language, different land, different relative. I have to react according to the word and the deen and the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So I have to love for the sake of Allah. I have to hate for the sake of Allah. I couldn't keep and use my own desire and my own feeling for my own business or my own desire or my own benefit. I have to do it, I have to spend it and to act and use it for the sake of Allah. Also, to give and to or to not give or to deny. I have to do it also for the sake of Allah. I have to give charity or advice or help for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I have to use it for the sake of Allah azza wa jal. Not to give our money just because of the relative or neighbor or some, you know, benefit from. No, I have to use it also for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even if they are very far from me or they are not relative. I have to give for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, I have to stop giving or deny the money from people who are using it against the religion of Allah, against the rules of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, against the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even if they are my own beloved, my own people. I have to use, I have to give, I have to deny for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, for the marriage, the person shouldn't get married or accept for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It means to marry according to the way, according to the rules, according to the recommendation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So also for the marriage, I have to do it, I have to practice, I have to act according to the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the Prophet said, فَمَنْ فَعَلَ ذَلِكَ فَقَدْ اسْتَكْمَلَ الْإِيمَانُ. Whosoever have done according to that, he is the one who has perfected and completed his faith, his iman. This is the faithful person, this is the pious person, this is the dutiful, the true, dutiful and the sincere believer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because he was using his actions and his feeling, his desire for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah azza wa jal accept our deeds. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide our hearts, our feeling, our desires to be according to the religion and the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله تعالى لي ولكم وجزاكم الله تعالى كل خير. Oh,